ensemble come up now. This group did a really nice job yesterday. They did get a first at state and did advance to state, as well as all the other ensembles you see here, first half of the concert. The piece you're going to do is a piece called Canzone per Signore No. 2 by the Italian composer Giovanni Gabrielli. Okay? And this is what we call a polyphonic piece, meaning you're going to hear a melody on top of a melody on top of a melody. So in essence, you might have a melody going 5 or 6 times all on top of each other. Really makes it, it can make it a challenging piece to play any Gabrielli type of arrangement where you have all these melodies on top of each other. So this is a woodwind ensemble of Canzone per Signore No. 2. Girls kind of work all on themselves to work on this piece, and I thought it would be very fitting with all the hard work they did to kind of be able to present it here for you today. They're going to do a movement from a piece entitled The Flute Garden, and it's kind of a really fun, frolicky piece, kind of has all different movements based on scenes in the garden. And the movement they're going to be doing this afternoon is a piece called Rockin' Roses. So this is the Flute Quartet.
Thank you.
off the first half of the program. And again, with the Jazz Ensemble, too, went to state yesterday. They got a first at state as well. The judge was very impressed with them. They did a fantastic job. So they're going to come on here and get set up. While they get set up, Mick Sound's out there somewhere, I think, isn't he? Yeah. Asked me to announce about the Music in the Park free concert summer series coming up this summer. The first concert's going to be on June 3rd here in Anago. That'll be the Anago High School Jazz Band. And there'll be concerts throughout the summer on Monday and Thursday evenings, usually at City Park. If it's raining, they go to the Heinz and Peaceful Valley Pavilion, which is a fantastic spot as well. But every Monday and Thursday nights, there's concerts going on. Just a variety of groups coming here. We've got Hip Pocket coming on July 1st. I know the community band has some special activities here at the high school on the 4th of July for the fireworks, and it just goes throughout all summer. It's just a great program. One thing I did want to mention as well, too, I know Music in the Park is always looking for business sponsors. Our concert with the Jazz Ensemble on the 3rd could be sponsored by Brickner's of Anago, and the Music in the Park committee really rely on those sponsors to help fund and keep the Music in the Park series going. So if you're really interested and you're part of a business would like to sponsor a concert, please see any of the Music in the Park committee members, and they can certainly help you out with that, and that really helps keep that concert series going. Sharon Gibson's on that, Carol Phillips, Nick Salm, as well, are kind of on that board, and they kind of help facilitate those concerts in the park during the summer. So again, that's coming up June 3rd. I know there's brochures all over town about this. It's just a great series. I always say it's a great way to introduce young kids to the arts, to bring them to the park and have them listen to a live group. Just a fantastic series that has been developed over the years here in Anago. We're going to continue on here with the Jazz Ensemble. And the first piece we're going to do is a Latin piece called Night of the Living Chili Pepper. And it's going to feature Ben Brown on alto sax and Lucas Dion on trumpet.
Thank you.
failed to mention also Rebecca Ingebretson on the piano with that little solo over there, too. All right, the next piece we're going to do is a piece called Lewd Indigo by Sammy Nestico. And Sammy Nestico is just a great arranger for the Duke Ellington Band. He came up with a lot of novel concepts in arranging for jazz, and this was certainly a typical piece of his. It's kind of one of these pieces where it's hard to tell where the melody and the accompaniment is. You don't usually have the trumpet on the melody, you have some background parts going on, but we have a kind of a real odd mix of combination of instruments. And you know, Sammy Nestico and Duke Ellington were really good at doing this, kind of disguising the arrangement, kind of doing things that you typically don't hear in a jazz ensemble. So this is Sammy Nestico's Lewd Indigo. Was first written, but this is a piece by Frank Mantooth, and you know, very prolific composer. You know, obviously he died really early. He was down at UW Stevens Point for a number of years. Just a lot of great writing that he did, and a lot of arrangements, not only for jazz but for jazz combo. And this is a down tempo piece. It's going to feature Lucas Dion on the mellophone. So this is Oneida. interview for Jazz Ensemble was a Latin, up-tempo Latin chart called Samba-ti Kai, and it's kind of an Afro-Cuban type of chart, really fun piece. It's going to feature Ben Brown alto sax and Lucas Dion on the trumpet. So Samba-ti Kai.
Thank you.
intermission here, about 10 minutes to reset the stage, get the rest of the band out. There is food and refreshments out in the comments. Feel free to check that out. There's a 50-50 raffle going on there back by James and Nick area back there. So you can purchase a 50-50 raffle, and we'll announce that winner right before our last piece. There's also some senior pictures back there and some other stuff for you to take a look at. So we'll be back in about 10 minutes with the full band. Thank you. The first piece we're going to do with a full band out here is a piece called Brighton Beach, and it's one of those rare marches that's done in a minor key signature. Most of the marches you hear, like the Sousa marches, are in a happy major key. This one happens to be in a minor key signature, and kind of works really neat with this march. It kind of, you know, usually you see it here, minor pieces, supposed to be sad, slow pieces, but this minor march really works well. It has kind of a resolute type of feeling to it. So this is Brighton Beach March.
Thank you.
selection we're going to do is a piece called Second Suite Enough by Gustav Holst. Kind of a really landmark piece of the band literature, the first suite and the second suite that Holst did write in the early 1900s. The first and second suite, Holst wrote basically English folk songs. All these movements are based off of English folk songs, and he turns them around, plays with the melodies a little bit, and kind of a really neat effect. The only folk melody you might recognize is in the fourth movement, the Fantasia. You might hear the Greensleeves melody in that fourth movement, but kind of a unique writing, unique work by Gustav Holst, second suite in F.
Thank you.
marching band stuff. Some of the best music has takes the most unexpected turns sometimes. And this is an original suite by Gordon Jacob, English composer. And he wrote this suite. First one was March, and he's a real cool composer because he takes a lot of unusual twists and turns. Where you start out in a piece is not likely where you're going to end up. And you'll kind of hear this piece going to a lot of different tangents on it. And I think that's a real hallmark of a great piece of literature, one that is unexpected, one that takes you places where you're not really thinking you're going to be going to. So this is a march from the original suite by Gordon Jacob. Here, all right? So, the first one, All right, first one, Simone Lanik in the flute section. She is going to UW-Stevens Point, and she's going to be in elementary education. All right, in the trumpet section, Lucas Dion. He's going to North Central Technical College, and he's going to get an associate's degree in wood science. And she's going into animal science and pre-vet studies. Back in the trombone section, Keegan Walrath, he is planning on attending NTC next year. UW-Stout. He's going to go into graphics design and video game design. So Jacob. All right, flute. Rebecca Ingebretson. She's going to Concordia University in Chicago. She's going into deaconess studies. Going to Michigan Tech, he's going to be going into civil engineering. All right, could we have all the seniors stand up? Please be recognized. Thank you, seniors. Okay, is James in the house there with the 50-50 raffle. We got tickets. All right, he's right on top of things. I like that, James. All right, we have a 50-50 raffle winner. $95 to the 50-50 winner. So let's have one here. Keep it neutral.
All right.
All right, get your tickets out here. We have 133058. 133058. Oh, we got a winner right down here. All right. Yeah, go right back to the table at the end of the concert. Pick up your 50-50 winnings. Thank you for supporting that. I appreciate that. All right, we're going to bring Simone up here. So Simone has something to say.
Good afternoon, everyone. Can everyone hear me? I'm quiet. Okay. So as you may know, this is Mr. Dewey's last spring concert here in the Antigo School District, and we just wanted to recognize all he's done for us throughout the years. So Mr. Dewey, thank you so much for all you have done for the band and each student. You have made a difference in our lives one way or another. Thank you for all the laughs. We will always cherish those memories. Thank you for all the learning experiences, whether that would be during silent rehearsals or not so silent rehearsals. We will always look back on them when needed. Thank you for all the silly nicknames you gave to us. We'll never forget them. But most importantly, thank you for being our band director. We wouldn't be half the musicians we are without your input and advice. We're all going to miss you, but we wish you the best in your future endeavors. Thank you again.
All right, thank you, Jacob. All right. Thank you very much. A lot of you guys who have known me for quite some time know that, you know, I'm not in this for the accolades or anything. I'm not one of those people say, well, look what I've done. I've done this, this, and this, and this. And that's not about it. From day one, 20 years ago, when I stepped into the job, it was about the students. What can I do as a teacher to make conditions favorable for these guys to be successful? And that takes a lot of forms. It takes, you know, obviously teaching, getting equipment set, defending the program if I have to, but anything I have to do to make these students successful. That's what it's all about. The job of a teacher since I started in 1999 has exponentially increased the demands on a teacher, but I always think back to that one precept I had coming into day one. It's about making these guys successful back here. And I thank you for the 20 years here. You guys have been supportive. My colleagues have been amazing all the way back from the late Dave Baer, Wayne Anderson, all the way up through my colleagues now. They've been amazing. I couldn't have made that journey alone without them. Thank you to all the community members supporting the arts here. I feel I'm leaving this program in a good spot. Next year, we have about 120 students in the high school band. It's going to go up from there. So those of you guys who are underclassmen, I urge you to stick with it, stay in the program. This program is going nowhere but up, and I have really high hopes and high aspirations for the future. So again, thank you very much. Thank the students. Thank you guys for 20 years. It's been a wild ride, but no, I certainly will look back with fond memories on it. So thank you very much. Thank you. We got one more piece for us to do. We're going to do an arrangement of Pirates of the Caribbean from the movie series. Obviously, Johnny Depp was really big in that one. We have a great symphonic arrangement of that. So we'll finish with Pirates of the Caribbean today.